What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more ABBA, back with more from their 1975 self-titled album, and we're up to the tune I've Been Waiting For You. And what you're about to hear, I think, I have one of those toys for Luca where it's like a wand with a multicolored ribbon on the end. You'll see it right here. And she's a big fan of this, but now she basically carries this around by the stick all on her own. So, yeah, we'll see what commotion she gets up to, because she normally bangs it against everything as she's running around. So, if you hear anything off camera, that's what you're hearing. Nevertheless, the tune I've Been Waiting For You, it speaks to anticipation. My inclination is to think it will be not only in terms of time, but also emotion. So whether that's on a short-term level, like you're going to have a special meeting with someone, maybe you're going to propose, or maybe it's just a culmination of a very special time together and you're actively waiting for them to arrive. Or it could be the idea that someone's been in your life for a while, you have strong feelings for them, but maybe at first it doesn't seem like it's being reciprocated, but over time perhaps they come to see the value or the quality that is on offer, and maybe recognizing that there is a possibility for a special connection and therefore turning their attention to you. So I've Been Waiting For You could be on a longer term. If I'm inclined to guess, I would say maybe more likely shorter term, though again, even that might not be strictly speaking physically, like, I've been waiting for you at this place on this special evening. It might be more, I've been waiting for this moment for a long time given our connection. So yeah, we'll see what it is, but this is ABBA, I've Been Waiting For You, making sure she's not directly under me. And it's from the 1975 self-titled album.
I've been in love before. I thought I would no more. Managed to hit the sea.
It remains confusing forever, right?
Still, strange as it seems to be.
Thank you. That part that goes really high at the end of the measures, was that just a little guitar lick? When I first heard it, it sounded like something else, but I think maybe that's what it was. And again, you know, I have a complicated feeling about fade endings, but that one felt more appropriate. Number one, it was gradual, and it was repeating the same vibe multiple times, so it felt like that was an appropriate and fitting fade out. My cat is literally eating everything, attacking everything. This is, you know, Luca is on the prowl this evening, is what I mean to say. But it's a cool tune, and like I said, it felt actually like it was more long-term, even though, as I said, if I had to guess in advance, I was thinking it might be more, you know, I've been waiting for this moment for a long time. Which I guess even then it would be kind of a mixture of short and long term, right? But yeah, it felt like she was essentially saying, I'll make you mine at some point. And like, you know, I'm here, I'm putting my life before you, and at some point, you know, we'll be together and you're gonna be very happy about that. So, yeah, sweet tune. It had a bit more slow and tender feel. It still had some energy, still had some pop to it, but it wasn't quite as rocking as some of the other tracks that I've gone through recently from them. So, and I would say, you know, a bit more mellow than Intermezzo number one, which is fantastic. So yeah, let me know what you think of this one. And again, there were a couple vocal moments there where it's like, oh my goodness, like just the vocal quality is unbelievable. So yeah, and of course, right as I'm gonna end the video, she sits on my lap. It's ridiculous. So now I have to feel like a villain for picking you up. But yeah, do let me know what you think. Luca and I will be here with all the hijinks next time. Peace.